And this one here, I thought this fight was over. It's round five. Extra innings, folks. You get the bonus round right now. It's Sean Jones going to town. This is round five here. Jones has won the first four. But also going to the body, you want to drop the guy's arm so he can go to the head.
That's right. That's the whole activity, putting combinations together. Now here we go in that Shears just took another beautiful, two good punches there. He seems to be a little hurt here. Another punch in just a second. Jones is landing some good heavy blows on the Shear right now.
The shark smells blood, Polly.
Yep, and Jones is landing some good leather, but the Shear is the type of guy that takes him and seems to come back too. He's not only a good catcher, he's a good pitcher.
Eskia looks to be a little groggy, a little wobbly on those legs. He's backed up into the ropes. Eskia now took a left hand from Jones. Look at Jones, just measure him now, Polly. Picking him apart.
Yep, Eskia is a little hurt and wobbly right now. He took some good punches, but you notice right there, just a second ago, Eskia is still visually trying to come back, and that's a tough opponent. Believe me, he's going to give him a lot of credit for the gameness, and they're two both good fighters, but you got to give a lot for his share. He's making the fight by keep coming back.
You can,
any one of those punches, he had a right to lay down legitimately, you know.
You see the redness on the back of Eskia, where some of the punches have connected. Now Jones and Eskia both exchange blows. Like you said, Paul, these are megaton bombs they're throwing.
Yep, they're really, really letting them go. They're not as fast and as rapid, but when they're throwing them for keeps.
Throwing them for keeps. I like that one. We'll put that one on the T-shirt, Paulie. Now they're tied up right in front of us. This is round five. Nick Previty separating the fighters. Likes to talk to them, say, hey, keep it clean. Now Jones once again connects to the head of Eskia. Eskia does look tired. He looks groggy.
Yeah, he's real tired, and Jones has got the edge on him. But they both are tired. Eight count going on right now because Eskia is catching a lot of heavy blows. So Pavetti, as a good referee, is looking into his eyes, seeing if he's all right. And if he was really hurt, he would see it in his eyes.
Eskia, his nose is bloodied and his confidence shattered. Right now, Jones going to town, and in fact, I think he's got a room. He's just measuring him now, Polly. He started, as you can see, Eskia's blood now is on the shoulder of Jones, but he started going to the body, and now he's starting to go to the head because he's opened that up.
Well, he sees that Eskia is tired and he's got him hurt. So when you got an opponent hurt, you got to go after him and keep that hurt on and hit with some more punches. If he lands more punches now, he's got a good chance of taking him out, and that's what he's trying to do right now. But Eskia is a game fighter, and what Jones got to watch out, he doesn't poop himself out because Eskia is liable to come back again.
That's Sean Jones, round five, dominating this fight. That is the end of the fifth round, as Paulie said. You know, he's got to put him away because unless you put him away, then that corpse can all of a sudden spring to life.
That's right. And this is a fight I don't think is going to go the route because I think they're looking over Eskia's face. His nose is pretty busted up there. He's very tired, but he's just taking some heavy blows in there. And these judges, the ring doctors up in the ring, and I think he's got a broken nose, and he might have to stop this fight. And I know their decision will be a good one, whether it's to go on or to stop it.
Well, they're asking for the ring doctor. Paul, let me ask you this. Do fighters have the cartilage removed in their nose?
Some fighters have done, a lot of fighters have done, especially back in the old days. And when they do that, take the cartilage out, because of the deviated septum, it seems to push over, and they can't breathe through their nose very well. But, you know, most of it, a lot of it is the art of boxing. You step back, you're breathing through your mouth a lot, too. But taking the cartilage out, it wasn't a great idea because the nose was just flattened right out after the next couple of fights. The noses will end up right close to their face. So in a lot of cases, they have to take them out. In some cases, you don't have to. You try to leave them in there.
Well, round six, they let Eskia come out and answer the bell for the sixth round. Jones going to town immediately. Jones has been the busier of the two fighters, obviously. He has dominated this fight from the get-go. Now he rocks Eskia, whose arms are down by his side. Eskia in trouble. Oh, my. Jones laying the hurt on Eskia here in the sixth round. Dangerous, Polly, when your hands are down by your side.
Yep, Eskia just landed a marvelous left hook on Jones's right side of his head. So Eskia is always dangerous here, always dangerous.
Yeah, Eskia spattered in his own blood, and now he's rocked again.
He's very, very tired. He's throwing desperating punches, and Jones has got to watch out. He's going to get caught one of them wild. There's a good combination by Eskia right there.
You caught it, Paul.
There he goes. You see, he's a very spooky fighter. You think he's going down. Next minute, he comes out there like a Flash Gordon, you know.
You caught that, Paul. I mean, right as we said, Jones got it. All of a sudden, Eskia kicks the coffin open and says, here I am.
So
So he's got you bewildered at all times. It looks like he's going down. Next thing he comes out punching to beat the band. And he's got Jones bewildered, I know that.
And as you said, in this weight class, every punch, if it connects, is lethal.
As you notice, and Askia's getting some good shots right now. He's landing on Jones. And the worst thing that can happen to a fighter is when you're hitting a guy with everything but the kitchen sink and nothing's happening, and then he comes back on you. That takes a lot out of a fighter, too. So Jones might be getting a little let down here. You know.
Yeah, he hits Askia there, and Askia now just clinging to Jones for dear life there. He was just heading down, and it looked as though he was ducking underneath and just taking the brunt of the punishment. Couldn't even raise his arms, Paulie.
Yep, that's the way it looks at all times. I don't know how he's taking those heavy punches from Jones. But Jones took some good punches, coming back again. Jones is a good fighter, good tough kid. The skier is a real a spooky fighter. He's very dangerous. He takes a tremendous amount of abuse, as you can see. But he's still in that fight. He's still in that fight.
Wow. Jones now. Moments ago, he just stung Askia with a left hand. Now Jones ducks underneath and tries to lift up Askia. Both teams, as you mentioned, both fighters, Paulie, as you mentioned, are getting tired.
Yep, they're real tired. They throw some heavy leather. Jones still has a little more of a bounce left to him and a little more of ability left to him. So he seems to be the better fighter as far as condition is concerned. And putting his punches together. Askia has caught too many heavy blows. It slowed him down, but he's still dangerous. Every so often, he comes out with a real, real barrage. So Jones has got to watch out for those barrages. Doesn't get caught coming in, and he might get a surprise and find himself on his back. That's the danger of lunging after an opponent, thinking he's hurt all the time. You keep running in after him and keeping yourself open to be hit.
Well, the partisan crowd responding here. That was a dandy, Paulie. Six rounds of action. As you said, Jones couldn't put him away, and Askia was a game fighter. Showed a lot of bravado there.
Well, we've been seeing that all night. You know, Askia taking a tremendous amount of abuse, but game fighter, tremendous amount of heart. And Jones, a great fighter, a tremendous amount of heart. Put two guys like that, you get a great, great fight out of it. And that's what the people came to see. And tonight, they're seeing it. They're seeing those type of fights tonight. And give them both a lot of credit. To me, I know that Jones is going to take this fight. But to me, both of them really want it. But both of them in two different aspects. One is given all that heart, taking all that abuse, catching and pitching as well. But both of them did do so. You got to give credit to both of these guys. Yeah.
That's Jim Tuberosa saying, hey, you'll see here. Sean Jones gave us a wink when he walked by, Paulie, saying, I had this one from the word go. He did. It was a tough opponent, but he did dominate this fight.
Definitely had the fight. Definitely had the fight. And like I say again, it's great to have an opponent like Askia to bring out the best in Jones. And Jones knows what it is to be hurt and knows what it is to dish it back.
Sean Jones with a unanimous decision in this heavyweight bout over Muhammad Askia.
We'll now have a 10-minute intermission, and then we'll have...
And we're going to take a break, and we'll be right back on ABT before our marquee bouts. Stay with us.